Okay, guys, this is what happens when you recycle your cat's food can. Because Jazz, I washed it, she still smells it. So she came here and sat on my desk, I think in protest, because I don't think she likes me using her can. Huh, Jazz? You're so funny. But I'm still going to use it because I need to make another pin cushion. So, anyways, be careful when you use your cat's empty food cans because she obviously can still smell it. And now she's going to hang out on my craft table. So, we'll see if I can get her off in a minute. Just wanted to show you folks some fabrics that I got on sale at Joann's, and I actually just got a quarter of each one because I thought that would be plenty for pin cushions. So, anyways, look at this one. Gorgeous. And they were 50% off, so even better. And then I had a coupon from Michael's that they honored. And it was 20% off, so I got a good deal. I feel pretty good. So, anyways, I'm going to look at these, and if I see something that I may want to do another project with, I can always go back and get more. But those are what I got for pin cushions. And then Katie got a couple things. I think this one's a fairy. She liked the little fairy girl. So she got that to color, and then she got this princess face, which I think I'm going to just have her paint because she loves to paint too. So anyway, she'll be back tomorrow, so we'll get to play with that. So this is what I did so far. I hot glued my dewdrops in there just to give it some weight, and then I'm going to pick one of these and get started on it, and I'll come back and show you the finished product. So hang tight. Hey guys, it's Carlene the Pink Scrapper, and I finished not one but two pin cushions today. I first did this one here, and I had so much fun that I went ahead and did another one. This one was fun because the challenge was the bottom, the base, and I like them to sit higher, but I didn't really have another spool handy, so I had something like this, and the circles here were flat, floppy, so I took it off and just had this inner circle, and I actually ended up cutting it in half and then wrapping fabric around like this one. And this one, after I got it wrapped around, I decided not to use it, so I'm going to save this for another trip or another pin cushion or give it to Kaylee for a bracelet. Just kidding. Alrighty, so here is my finished pin cushion, and again, thanks to Donna, who's 123 card maker, because she got me addicted to these with her tutorial. So if you want to learn how to make this, head over to her channel at 123 card maker. And so this is the spool that I cut in half, and then I needed a base, and I have the black chipboard in my store, and so I decided to just cut a 3.5 by 3.5 square, and then I angled it there, wrapped two strands of this gold pearl, which I'm really starting to like. It just adds some classy glimmer and bling to my project. So you'll see a lot of this in my projects lately. I had this bead trim here. I also covered the can the cat food can with some black cardstock because I didn't have black felt handy. And I ended up covering it with some lace, with some black lace anyway, so it didn't matter. And then here is the pleated black satin ribbon, which I used to make this flower as well. This was one I had in my stash, and I already had the pin and the feather attached and the flower, and so I just glued it on and it was pretty much done. Now I did use some of Halud's trim that she gave me in a rack, and it's this one here and then this one that's wrapped around the cat food can, and then the fabric I got from Joann's. And so I've got some pins that I got from a pin swap a long time ago that match the fabric, and so that is the finished piece. And it's so much fun once you get started. You're going to walk around your house looking for cans and things that you can make, that you can use in your pin cushions. Okay, so here's my smaller pin cushion. And like I said, I made this for it, and I was going to do that and then put a base on it, and I just decided not to for some reason. I had this flower that I made handy. And this is just seam binding. This is some lace or some ribbon trim that I got a long time ago in LA. And then I just layered some laces here. I did stitch this one and gather the top so I could have this nice ruffle. And then put some of my favorite braid trim there. Again, you're seeing the gold pearls, this gorgeous oriental fabric with some pink pins in there. And what I'm going to probably add here is a pink feather. And then on the bottom, you can still see the bottom of the can. I'm going to get some more pink felt and cover that up, and then also get those round wood balls. And probably paint them white or pink and then glue them to the bottom of this so it gives it a tad, like a half an inch of height. So anyways, this is my second one that I made today. It's so fun, and they're so quick. Once you have, you know, your spools and your bases, and actually you don't really even need to. You can see this one doesn't have a base, but I like to put a base on it. It just I don't know, it's just my thing. So anyways, once you get all your supplies that you're gonna recycle in here and ready, you can do this so quickly. Anyways, hope you try it. Check out Donna's video, and I'll see you later. Have a great day.